Welcome to this new how-to. In this how-to, we will look at how you can add some additional stuff to your already complete Flight Simulator 2020 installation. Updates are released by the community, as well as paid additional additions like the Russian landmarks are being offered by vendors. The addons are available in a few types. You've got the planes and aircrafts, you've got the scenery, which exists both on, I would say, the countryside, but also specific airports which are being updated or added to the installation. And there are two main repositories on the internet which I use, and that one of them is the msfsaddons.org, which contains both freeware and payware. Freeware, as it already says, you can download it for free. Payware, you need to pay a small amount of money to download the software and before you can use it. The other one is nexusmods.com. It also contains all kind of additions to Flight Simulator. Keep in mind that you need to register an account to download the stuff. Compared to MSFS add-ons, you don't need an account. You can just click and it will download the file. So let's have a look at some add-ons which we can install. I already downloaded the aircraft P51 Racer prior to starting this recording in my downloads directory. So let's have a look. As you can see, here's the file P51.rar, and I will extract it to P51.rar. You can use your favorite tool to extract the file. In my case, I'm using 7-zip because I like it. You see a lot of files being extracted. The most important thing is that you need to copy the complete directory, so in this case the P51 directory, to the correct directory in a Flight Simulator installation. In most cases, like probably it's also in this one, it contains a README which contains some basic information about, okay, hey, what is it? What's the edition? Where do you need to put it, etc. So here it already states you need to put all folders in the community folder. But where is that community folder located? Well, let me show you. To do that, you need to open an explorer and you need to type in percentage local app data percentage, which will bring you to your app data local directory. Then you need to scroll a little bit down. In most cases, you open packages and then you will find a directory called Microsoft.FlightSimulator_ and then a weird GUI. That's only applicable if you install it from the store. If you are using it via Stream, it could be a completely different directory because Stream works differently. In that case, you need to go to the install directory and there you will find the community directory. In this case, where I installed it via the store, I need to open it. I need to go to local cache and then to packages and then to community. And inside the community directory, you can see already a lot of things being added, right? That's because I added some scenery, some liveries, some new airplanes, which I'm testing. And as mentioned in this README, we need to copy all those directories. So let's do that. So we will copy down here. And that completes the installation of the add-on. Keep in mind that once you added an add-on, you need to restart Flight Simulator before you can use the add-on. So this is the first way, but there is another way. And the other way requires you to install or to download the tool first. And that tool can be found on MSFS add-ons. And it's called the MSFS Mod Manager. It's an open source tool, so if you download it, consider to donate via PayPal to Skypad, which is the person who developed this tool. He's bringing regular updates to this tool, so that's cool. Of course, I already downloaded the installation, and if you extract the directory, you will find two files, or two files, a little bit more files. Sorry, I thought there were two. And the main file is the modman fx64. And as soon as you opened it, it will ask you, okay, what is the game root folder? But in this case, the root folder should be your community folder. Well, luckily enough, we already had it here, so we can copy the full path from here. Specify it here and then say select folder. It will tell you, okay, I added the game module tree structure successfully. So we can simply press OK. And one of the things you see is that it doesn't show the existing installed add-ons. That's currently not an option in this tool. So if you want to see all the existing add-ons, you need to remove them and reinstall them using this utility. So what we're going to do is we're going to remove the P51, which we just added. So let's install the mod. So we press add mod, we go to the directory. In this case, what we need to do is we need to find the file which contains the add-on. As you can see here, it's got P51, but what the tool actually needs is it needs the compressed directory or the compressed folder. So let me have a look, because maybe I deleted it. No, it's called, it's a RAR, and as far as I can see, it doesn't support RARs yet. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna I'm gonna go to the P51 directory and create a P51.7z, which is a 7-zip file. It will take a few minutes before it's done. So you see, in some cases you need to create a new compressed file because ModmineFX doesn't support all the compressed file types. It supports most of them, but the .rar one is the one it doesn't support, as it looks like. Maybe it will be added in the future, but let's see. Almost there. So we created the zip, so that's cool. And now we see the 7-zip file, so we select open. And what we'll do is we'll extract the files from the 7-zip file to the cache folder. So let's give it a few minutes. And then we would look in the background. We see that it didn't do something yet, because it now extracted it to a local cache file. So if we want to install it, we need to press the install mod one. As you can see, the current file is the P51.7zip. The stage is not installed. It contains some information about the creator, about the author, the version, etc. So let's hit install mod. And if we would go quickly to this directory, you will see that the directories are simply created in the correct location. Once installed, you will see that in the bottom of the screen contains an overview of all the files being added. So if you by accident delete one file, you can just reinstall it using the install file option. So in this tutorial, or in this how-to, we looked at how you can install add-ons. We looked at how you can install it manually, but also using the ModmineFX. If you like this video, don't forget to like the video. And if you like to see more of these kind of videos, not only how to use about using the tools, but also how to use certain features of Flight Simulator, then consider to subscribe. Thanks for watching and see you next time.